How is everyone feeling at this point in time? This is, of course, the Musty Moon Cricket. And we talk about the same boo-boo, oofoo, boo-boo, ooshoo. Same bullshit we always talking about. Now, today, we got a nice special on the menu for us. Today, we're talking about Destiny 2. Now, Destiny 2 is, of course, developed by Bungie. Bungie, of course, are the motherfucking daddies of basically Xbox. I mean, honestly, you ask me right now, Bungie is what put Xbox on the map. They made the most popular Xbox, basically, poster child. They made Master Chief for Halo. So, I mean, really, Bungie, honestly and truly, is Xbox. And it's kind of sad because now, starting with Destiny, Bungie decided to move outside of just the X. They said, oh, you know what I'm saying? We kind of the shit. We start getting some real bread. So they decided to say, yeah, let's incorporate Sony. Matter of fact, Sony doing their thing hella with the PS4. So we're gonna go with Sony and we're gonna advertise with them too. So Bungie, they've been doing their thing, and they put Halo, their previous baby, put it on letitgo.com, and 343 said, yeah, well, we'll take that. But yeah. So Destiny, developed by Bungie and published by probably the most universally hated basically publisher of them all, Activision. You know what I'm saying? Activision has published some great games. A lot of movie licensed games that weren't too well, which always makes them kind of look like unpopular. I feel like they're unpopular because they have very greedy business practices. They're not the worst, but I feel like that's what puts them on the map as being, like, you know, not one of the best. Like them, EA, I can't think anymore at the top of my head. But anyway, now let's get to this game. You know what I'm saying? Speaking of Destiny 2, you know what I'm saying? I got a decent history with the game. Not, I'm gonna say I got no crazy ass history. But like I said, when I remember Destiny 1 dropped, like April 2014. I remember that shit first drop. I went to that boy. I had some alpha testing underneath my belt, and I played the beta. So I went under there, you know what I'm saying? I feel like I knew the game. Played the full campaign, or air quote, campaign. And I thought it was decent. I mean, I think it was that bad. I mean, it was okay. Like, you know what I'm saying? It was very bland. Didn't really explain much. But it was like, whatever, you know what I'm saying? No one's really playing Destiny for the campaign. But you know what I'm saying, I noticed once I beat the game, that's when the game really starts. Same thing with Destiny 2. And you know what I'm saying, it just kind of had you kind of doing the same exact thing over and over again. Because you get your light level up and you just had to do a bunch of shit. You had to run a lot of the same missions over and over again, a lot of the same strikes, etc. You know what I'm saying, start releasing, you know, raids and raids to forever. And I just, you know, after a while, I probably put like 70, 80 hours in the game. And after a while, I just kind of fell off. I think at the time the maximum rank was like 29 or 30, and I hit like 26. So I was getting there, but I just really just after a while I was like, you know what, I just don't even give a shit anymore. So you know what I'm saying, I fell off Destiny 1, and maybe a year later I bought the Taken King, you know, made the game like a little bit better. So I played that shit, and you know, it was sweet, but didn't really fully capture me. I didn't beat in DLC. So then I just really like realized, like, yeah, I'm done with Destiny. So, yep, wrote Destiny off. Now I'm saying Destiny 2 came out. Played the beta for Destiny 2. Destiny 2 beta was a little bit lackluster compared to Destiny 1. So I was like, whatever, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to this beta, you know what I'm saying? Judge how the game's going to be to me. Whatever. Still went through with it. Played a little bit of Destiny, played Destiny 2, played the beta. You know what I'm saying? They picked the actual game up. And I'm gonna say, it's sweet. I mean, you know, I enjoyed the game. I talk about the story, okay? Because now, story, I guess I actually speak on the story more in Destiny 2 than I could in 1. Story's more so fleshed out. Like, this game has an actual story. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it has a... Basically, okay, we're gonna start off this bitch. Alright, so like, you playing as the Guardian. And you know what I'm saying, you guys, like, basically you guys' hub world was a tower. You know what I'm saying, you and your homies, you got everybody chilling at the tower having a great time. You know what I'm saying, everything seems to be peaceful. And then like, this dude named Cabal, or whatever the fuck his name is, I don't really know. This is stories, you know what I'm saying, you just kind of just take what you got from it. But some dude named Cabal just said, yeah, y'all motherfuckers thought y'all was living peaceful. Come, he pulls up in the tower. He starts blowing shit up, starts killing motherfuckers. Then, basically, in the end, he captures the speaker, I think his name is. I'm gonna look that up. I'm gonna have to correct myself in the video. But where the fuck he captures the speaker or whatever and destroys the light. Destroys the light. So, you know what I'm saying? Now the light's gone, now your ghost can no longer revive the guardian. Every guardian gets a ghost. Now the ghost can no longer revive the guardian. So now you guys are basically on your last leg. Like, once you guys are dead, you guys are done for. Like, guardians are dying. Oh, it's called the Traveler's Light. So he destroys the Traveler's Light, just to add a little bit more context to it. Yeah, so he destroys the Traveler's Light. Whatever. Boom. So basically, the whole story is just you restoring the Traveler's Light, rescuing the speaker, and killing Cabal and his lieutenants. That, honestly, that's the story in a nutshell. Like, the story, everybody keeps highlighting the story, but, like, I mean, honestly, truly, it's like a regular first-person shooter story. Not bad, but it's, like, nothing crazy. You know what I'm saying? They give you a couple new characters. They may give you this one chick who, like, fucking has an owl or a hawk that flies around, and I guess she's a big part of the story. Now it's face painted. Some dude who, like, snipes people. And then you got, of course, like, every single guardian lieutenant. Ikora, which is, like, the she's, like, the guardian leader for the vanguards. Forgot the guy's name who leads the Titans. He's, I guess he's pretty cool, whatever. And the really popular one, Nathan Fillion. The one who, like, his name's not Nathan Fillion. He is the Hunter's leader. His name's Cade. He's played by some actor named Nathan Fillion. And I had no idea. I kept saying, like, oh, yeah, Nathan Fillion. I had no idea who the fuck Nathan Fillion was. And then I looked him up on, like, IMDb and shit. And, like, one of his movies was Saving Private Ryan. And I was like, where the fuck was he in Saving Private Ryan? And then I thought back and I was like, oh, shit. He wasn't Saving Private Ryan. He was that one motherfucker they thought was Ryan. But they messed up. Like, it was bad information. So, like, he was the dude who, like, thought his brothers died, and they're like little kids, and started crying and breaking down and shit. And they're like, oh, wrong Ryan. He was that dude. So I guess that dude's fucking funny or something. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I mean, Kay was, like, supposed to get the comic relief, but he was fucking corny. Whatever. That's really the story in a nutshell. I mean, the story was cool. I played through it. It takes probably, like, fucking, well, like, 5 to 7 hours. I feel like it don't take long. You can get through it in one sit down. And then basically, once you beat the story, you basically are kind of maxed out level 2. The story basically gets you to level 20. Anyway, moving on from that part of the game, talk about the fucking gameplay and how that shit is. And first, I'm gonna say off rip, the gameplay is the same as Destiny 1. Let's be fucking real with one another. Gameplay is like damn near fucking peak for peak Destiny 1. Like the aiming down sights, the enemies. Fucking just mechanics, everything is just like Destiny 1. If you did not like Destiny 1, especially for its gameplay, do not pick this shit up. It is, this game right here is catering to the fans of Destiny 1. It is not, it seems like by playing the shit, it is not trying to bring in any from it. Now with that being said, the gameplay, I like Destiny 1's gameplay. So I had no problem with this game gameplay. So, yo, mechanics of the game, sweet as hell. Smooth shooting, you know what I'm saying? Like, the guardians control smooth. You know what I'm saying? The game, it did. I played for consoles, obviously. I mean, everyone who had this game now has played for consoles. It released for PC. I don't know, maybe like in a month. I don't know what day it released for PC, but PC comes later. But anybody, like, for, like, it being 30 frames per second, like, the game plays smooth. Like, the graphics are good. You know what I'm saying? It feels good to, like, light the motherfuckers up. The guns feel sweet. This game has a shitload of guns. Like, they have, like, varying from, like, scout rifles, like, with basically semi-automatic guns, pulse rifles, like, energy-based weapons, using 3 bursts, auto rifles, SMGs, shotguns, snipers, rocket launchers. They even got now in your most powerful slot, you can get a fucking sword. I don't think they had that in Destiny 1, but, I mean, I didn't play that far into Destiny 1, so, like, they got, we get a fucking sword and, like, The sword can be equipped anytime. A motherfucker come around the corner, you just hold triangle. I play PS4, by the way, so I'm playing triangle. Hold triangle, motherfucker slice and dice motherfucker up. Piece and taking bodies by stacking bodies. Like, the gameplay is sweet, you know what I'm saying? Like, when you're playing through the campaign, something that was given you really early in the game, which is the Sparrow, they kind of save that shit to be here at level 20. I'm guessing they do that to, like, maybe kind of, like, kind of give the story a little more legs so you don't go through it too quick. And maybe so you can kind of walk around and enjoy the scenery, because the game has, like, 4 or 5 planets in. And the planets are pretty sweet, too. They look good. All the planets look pretty good. So maybe they want it to, like, have it to where you don't get the Sparrow until, like, you know what I'm saying, until you beat the game. So you actually rush through that shit in the later game. And another thing about the later game, like, the game really blossoms after you beat it. That's the weirdest part about this game. Like, we're playing through the campaign, and it's like, you can go through that shit. You can go through that shit in a day. Where the game really shines is in all the shit you can do after you beat it. I mean, like, you know what I'm saying, for example, like, not only, like, once you're in the campaign, they got side activities, which I don't think is the Destiny 1. All the side activities you can do around the world, kind of give you, like, you know what I'm saying, like, get your light up there. Because once you beat the game, once you hit level 20, you still have this bar that shows you leveling up. But then once you hit that cap, you get these, like, engram that lets you go back to the crypt art and get some shit for it. So it's still, you know what I'm saying, you still feel rewarded for going around and doing bullshit. Anyway, so you got side activities, you got the Crucible, which is, like, you know what I'm saying, the multiplayer, basically PvP aspect of the game. And I think I'm talking that for a second. I'm going to highlight that for a second. The Crucible, you know what I'm saying, in this game is sweet. Like, I play the Crucible, it's probably, like, what a lot of people that play Destiny, I don't think really fuck with the Crucible like that. Like, it's good, but it's, like, not the highlighting aspect of the game. Like, Destiny, honestly, is, like, a cooperative game. Like, a lot of people play it, like, raid together, going strikes together, just go around and grind together. And I feel like the Crucible, even though you can't still get loot from it, is the least, like, grindy part of the game. Like, a lot of people just kind of hop in that shit. Maybe they're bored. You can't hop on Destiny, like, maybe an hour, so just hop in Crucible real quick, so they can get something cool for it, or, like, hop off and do something else today. Like I said, like, you know, so we got the Crucible, a couple game modes of Crucible. I think now, I don't know what it was in the past, in Destiny 1, I don't know, it was 5v5 or 6v6, but now it's 4v4, and which is pretty badass. I think they upgraded to four-person fire teams now. I don't remember if it's still 3 fire teams or 4 fire teams. I know I did one place on Wings for a hot second, and we had 4, but we didn't go on any missions to play the Crucible. So I don't know if you can bring that into outside the Crucible, but I'm pretty sure you can. Anyway, you know what I'm saying? And other than the Crucible, once you get, like, your light level up really high, probably, like, 250 and above, because, but little side note, light leveling, like, in the old Destiny, when you get your light level up before they did the patch, that shit was hard as fuck. Like, that shit took forever. This one, I will say, I do like. It's so much easier. Magnitude's easier. You literally go in that bitch and you start playing, and it's literally, majority of the time, the loot that falls, and especially when you're leveling up from, like, 100 up, 100's like 250, everything that drops is usually stronger. Your light level goes up really quick. Anyway, but once you get that 250 mark and up, that's to start going on, like, the Nightfall Strikes and, like, you know what I'm saying, raiding the Leviathan and shit. I'm like, well, I play the Nightfall Strike, which is this straight. I mean, like, I'm a person, like, I like playing Destiny, but, like, I don't fuck with the raid. That's somebody that I'm somebody that you can't, you know what I'm saying, take my review, or everyone to call this, with a grain of salt, because I do not fuck with the raid. The raid, honestly and truly, I've heard people talk about it. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's different now because they've put time in it already. They've experienced it. But that, I heard that shit takes, like, 8 hours. Like, it's, like, fucking 4, maybe what, minimum 4 hours? Like, what the fuck? Playing one goddamn thing for 4 hours? And I heard, like, I'm pretty sure you do, but, like, you might get some badass loot. Like, fuck on, you're crazy. You think I'm about to fucking sit up there and play one thing for fucking 4 to 8 hours? Like, you're high. So I never really fucked with the light level. I mean, not light level, I never really fucked with the raid. And I heard the raid's pretty hard. I mean, that's pretty badass. Yeah, you need a fire team. Like, they made it to, like, where you need a fire team of 6 people. And just, you know what I'm saying, I like just kind of hopping on Destiny whenever I can. And just, you know what I'm saying, playing, going on some patrol missions, which is another activity doing on the side. You know what I'm saying, just collecting that little small loot. I mean, I got my light level up pretty good. I think I'm like 250, 260 now. And I think that's good enough to talk about the game. I'm gonna play it throughout the year. I'm not that person that just like play it and make this video and like, oh, I'm done with the game. So a lot of my friends are trying to get it now. So I still gonna play that shit, but like just that whole like right now I'm not rushing. I'm not trying to be like goddamn, you know what I'm saying, top of the world right now, ranking leaderboards, you know what I'm saying? Like no. Even though there's no ranking leaderboard, but still like I'm not trying to prove up to nobody. I just play Destiny. I'm more of a casual Destiny player, but I'm not that person to shit on Destiny. I think Destiny's actually a good game. You know, I mean, so I guess when I bring it around to, like, you know, my wrapping up thoughts, but, like, yo, I mean, actually, like, it's the same thing as I say about any game. Like, you know what you're getting into going into Destiny 2. Like, I mean, a lot of anybody who's going to Destiny 2 has some kind of idea what Destiny is. And I'm not sure now, if you like Destiny, you're going to like the shit out of this game. You're going to like this game, like, fucking facts. Like, there's no reason you would, like, if you like Destiny 1, you would not like this game. But, you know what I'm saying, but the same thing can be said if you don't like this game. If you didn't like Destiny 1, there is nothing to bring you to Destiny 2. Like, the game is so goddamn similar to Destiny 1. It's so fucking similar. So that's why people call it Destiny 1.5. Like, because honestly and truly, like, I mean, like, I guess they're going with the method of, like, they really are catering to their fans. Like, they know who they're advertising to. They're advertising to people who play Destiny 1. Like, they people who still stuck with Destiny 1, grind that shit out, got their light level up, play all the DLC, expansions, all that shit, they're catering to them. They want to appease them. That motherfucker who said, man, fuck Destiny 1, that shit's trash. Fuck Activision, nah, fuck this expansion, blah, blah. They can give two shits about you. They said, all right, kick rocks, man. We don't want to give you our game anyway. So they gonna fucking cater to people who appreciate them. And that's why people who appreciate Destiny 1 absolutely fucking adore Destiny 2. Simple as that. I mean, like I said, me, I like Destiny 1. I wasn't as crazy and fucking grindy as people that play it, but like, still, like, I can appreciate the game. I mean, let's still be real. Like, the game has good mechanics, you know what I'm saying? It looks good. I mean, you can play with your friends. You can do everything you do in the game, you can do with a friend. Like, any game that's co-op like that, I mean, I really can't shit on it too heavy. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, shitty activities, dude. You know what I'm saying? Crucible. Oh, you got the fucking, the Strike, the Nightfall Strike. You got the fucking Raid, Patrol, side activities. Like, the game is filled with content. In the game, starting off, has a lot more gear and weapons than it did in Destiny 1. Like, I'm saying, like, I mean, and then, like, and then all three classes are back. You got the fucking Hunter. I play as a Hunter. But them bitches are back. They're pretty sweet. Still good. Still the fastest class. Most finesse class. Then you got the Titans. Still bulky shit. Side note, Titans got the sweetest fucking armor. I kind of got pissed when I picked the Hunter. I was like, god damn. Like, this Titan looks sweet as shit. Like, I should have picked the fucking Titan. Damn. But anyway, yeah, you got the fucking Titan. And then I'm saying, then you got the Warlocks. And I'm not going to lie. Hey, man, face, scratch that shit. Warlock's got the sweetest fucking armor. Warlock's got some sweet-ass armor, too. I don't know what I did. Like, I thought maybe, like, all right, fuck it, I'll go with the Hunter again. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm going to do. I might down the line make me a Warlock and a fucking Titan, because they look sweet as shit. Like, I love their armor. Like Warlock got this sweet-ass, like, helmet they can find. They got these wings and fucking Hunters get, like, fucking fur, and they look sweet as shit. I'm not going to lie. Like, I bet the Hunters... If I say Hunters, let me say Hunters. I'm gonna say Titans. They got the fucking fur and shit. But Hunters, I don't know why they look the blandest to me. I'm like, oh, sweet, I got a cloak. Awesome, I got a unique helmet. Like, I don't know. Like, I feel like I should, like, cosmetic wise, should have probably picked either Warlock or a Titan. They look kind of sweet. And I play as a Hunter in Destiny 1. I mean, I'm probably gonna redo it and get me another class. But they all feel good as hell. All got three subclasses, which is sweet. And just say, like, I mean, Destiny 2, like, some people are going to shit on it, say it's ass, say don't play it, don't waste your money. But it's just, do your research, you know what I'm saying, watch a million reviews, if you're still on the fence about buying it. And if you're on the fence about buying Destiny still, you probably shouldn't even buy it. I mean, that means that you don't waste your money. I mean, you're probably not going to like the game like that. I I'm saying? Like, I mean, you, at this point in time, you should know if you're in Destiny 2 or not. I mean, like, either you like it or you don't. Like, some people out there fucking hate Destiny. I mean, I, like I said, I mean, like, alright, that's cool. You know what I'm saying? They might not like Destiny as... They seem to have pretty greedy business practices, which I agree with. All that expansion shit, whatever. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? Honestly, truly, look, I don't give my fucking final thoughts. You know what I'm saying? Story, they listened to the community a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Implemented more so of the story, so you kind of feel like you're not just playing some bullshit, tacked together stuff. It's an actual story in this one, which is good. And then, gameplay, like I said, Destiny 1 mechanically, gameplay was fucking tight. Gameplay was sweet. Like, the game felt good. All the subclasses were sweet. All the tight, all the three classes, they all felt good. You know what I'm saying? Shitload of weapons, shitload of different cosmetic items, everything you can think of. Different sparrows, different ghosts, different ships. All that shit comes in variation. One thing that the game was criticized heavy about still is the shaders now come in different quantities. Like, you might get 3 or 6 now and shit. You can get pissed now, limited. Something small, it's not a big deal to me. I mean, so that pissed some people off heavy, but you know what I'm saying? Whatever, but you know what I'm saying? They got shaders. You can find more stuff now. Throw your weapon, do all you can do. But like I said, like, you know, I actually get my final wrap my shit up. I've been talking for fucking, what, like, goddamn 22 minutes now, 21 minutes. Yeah, Destiny 2, like I said, you're gonna like it or you're gonna hate it. But my best advice is just, if you're that much on the fence about it, you know, maybe rent it. Do a GameStop rent. You know, do whatever you got, you know what I'm saying? If you're not liking it, take it back. If you like it, hey, the game has legs, you got longevity. It's gonna last you a minute. So, yeah, just, you know what you want, you know what I'm saying? Me, I'm just giving my opinion on it. Don't listen to shit I say. Don't let my fucking words mean shit. Even though it don't matter anyway. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? Listen, Destiny 2, me personally, hey, it's a good cop. I enjoyed it. You, hey, give it a shot. You might like it too.